Hello guys, welcome to my channel today. So I've been seeing you guys. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. And if you subscribe to my channel, please just drop a comment, okay? Let's support each other. You subscribe to my channel. If you have a channel, if you have a video on your channel, I'll be glad to support you too, okay? So let's talk about this pig transplant, this pig kidneys transplant. Who else have heard about pig kidney transplant? So let me tell you a little about it. So this news, it's all about kidney transplant. You know, kidney transplant these days in Nigeria is getting shorter and shorter. The shortage is too much. Even if it's available, it's costly. Like, people just purposely, they just sell their kidney, millions of naira. So the poor people who have kidney problems cannot even afford it. So me especially, I'm happy for this innovation, and we're hoping that it will work in the long run. So just few days ago, US Today reported that surgeons from New York have successfully transplanted a pig kidney into a brain dead human. And they said that immediately they put that kidney, it began functioning and producing large amount of urine within minutes of being connected to the person's blood vessel. So we have hope. And I went through comments on the social media, and I've started seeing people. Trust my African people, trust Nigerians. I've started seeing people saying they are going to start pig farming. That in fact, this is the time to start pig farming, you know, in case this thing works. What I'm making this video is, please, you guys, even if you start pig farming, okay, and we hope that this whole procedure works on human being, this pig kidney works on human being, and you start pig farming, I am begging you people, business people, try and keep it affordable. Because why they are trying this thing is so that people who cannot afford the human ones, people who are not able to get it from people who are not willing to give to people that are sick, who are not able to afford it, that is why they are, you know, going into this research, so that in case it works, that means people will have access, you know, to kidney without having any further problem or dying from it. So please, if you plan on going into pig farming, make sure to keep it affordable. Don't capitalize on this research where you not even put your hand into. Other people go do. Una go put una hand. They collect plenty money. Why other people go suffer? Do research. Now una go come, they collect big money from them. It's not good. So if you have pig farm, and you plan on opening pig farm, and this thing work, please, don't increase the price. Let poor people afford it. Let people who cannot afford the human one, let them afford the pig one, so that they can stay alive. Let's help people. Let's help ourselves in this life. As far as I'm concerned, things can be sold at $1, 1 cent, 1 naira. All this economic factor, economic factor, this factor, all these things are human factor. Price is going up, coming down, human factor. Somebody is just sitting in the office increasing price. We wake up today angry and say, no, the price of dollar will be 1,000 naira. He will just hike it. They wake up angry the next day. The price of dollar should have to be 700 naira. They will hike it. The price of milk today should be 2,000. They hike. Every every price you see going up and down, it is human factor. Let's be reasonable. This can actually be sold at $1. If we want it to happen, it will happen. Okay, if we want it to happen, it will happen. People are always demanding for goods. People are supplying. And we're even trying these days. We're exporting now. So why should dollar still be high? Why should things still be high? People are suffering. People are suffering. So let's not capitalize on this pig, kidney, whatever, and make sure that the poor people that they are making this whole thing possible for to not still get access to it by increasing the... I'm saying it now. Let me start early to hammer on it. Let me start early now to talk about it. Am I shouting? I don't think I'm shouting. But if I'm shouting, sorry. But let me shout so that people who are always looking for where to chuck their hand into, looking for how to increase the price of things, let them start now to know that it is not fair. If you do it, it won't be fair on your part. So if eventually this procedure, this research works in the long run, let us keep the price affordable, because that is the reason for this whole thing. That is the reason for this whole research, so that people can have access to kidney at an affordable price. So why a genetically engineered pig? People are asking, why a genetically engineered pig? Now, the transplant conducted on September 25th used a kidney that was obtained from a pig that had undergone editing to knock out a gene that codes for sugar molecule called alpha-gal. Alpha-gal is not normally found in humans, okay? And this molecule can elicit a devastating immune response in humans. So that is why they are using a genetically engineered pig. So even you that wants to start pig farming, your pig farming might not still be legal for this whole transplant. Your pig farming have to undergo a procedure, you know, before it can be used. Like I said before, they said why they are using genetically engineered pig is because this it has been found that pig has, you know, something called alpha-gal, and this alpha-gal is not normally found in humans. So why they use genetically engineered pig is to code for a sugar molecule called this alpha-gal, because this alpha-gal can cause a devastating immune response in human beings. So before you even think of, let's say this pig kidney works, start working on people. So before you start thinking of purchasing a pig to take the kidney to put, please make sure that it goes through all the processes it has to go through before it can work on a human being. Make sure, don't just go and buy pig and say, oh, they say pig kidney works, and you just go and buy pig kidney, take the kidney to the hospital. Or hospital people just take, you know, hospitals that are not well developed, they just take it and put it in you. Trouble. So make sure that the pig kidney has gone through all the processing it has to go through before it can be used on you. So we are hoping that it works so that people will be able to assess this thing and live longer. And if you know that there are things that you know you can do to stay away from kidney problem, because it's one or two things that happens that causes all these things. So if there are things you can do to stay away from it, please do. Drink lots of water, okay? Stay away from too much alcohol. Drink lots and lots of water. Stay away from too much alcohol. Live a healthy lifestyle. Let's help ourselves. Things are becoming costly. So if there's anything you can do to not get sick, please do. I usually tell people that, especially people that like to see, you see a food that is almost soured and you want to go and eat it. Do you know my response? When you are eating that soured food, think about the amount of money you're going to use to cure yourself when something happens, when there is a sickness. Think about the amount of money. So if that sour food costs 50 naira and the amount of money you're going to use to cure yourself is like 500,000 naira, my darling, please throw it away. Throw it away and live healthy. All right? Thank you so much. Bye, guys.